This video will show you how to draw and shade the bubbly sweet. Start with the outline, checking that you've got curves all the way around the edge and that your shape looks three-dimensional with the front bit, and add the shadow shape in there as well. Just have a look at the circles before you start drawing them in. Notice how they vary in size. They're not all the same size. Some of them are smaller, some of them are more circular and round, some are like squashed ovals. The ones around the edges appear to be a little bit smaller in some places. I've pressed down when I've drawn mine out, but make sure that you draw them a little bit lighter. I've done that so that you can see them on the video clearly. Make sure that your pencil is nice and sharp when you draw them out. You don't have to count all the bubbles exactly, you're just creating the impression of the sweet, having that texture with those bubbles. The bits on the front of the sweet are not totally circular, and some of them appear like they're sort of squashed on the side. So don't draw them as real circles, they should be drawn as oval shapes that are tucked into each other. I'm just blocking in the shadow now so that the whole drawing doesn't become too confusing, so I'm just putting in the shadows. Remember, when you do a shadow, you start off dark towards the edge of the object and then get lighter as you move further away. The next stage is to identify the three areas of tone across the sweet. The darkest area is the front bit, so I'm just going a little bit darker on there and putting a base layer down, but not going too dark and getting rid of all of the circles. Then on top of the sweet there are areas of shadow as well, I'm just blocking in. And then finally a layer of light shading across the whole sweet. The next stage is to go into it in more detail and select the areas of shadow and go even darker. So I'm going into the gaps in between the bubbles and adding some shadow in there. Make sure that your pencil is nice and sharp because the gaps are actually quite narrow. Whilst I'm shading in between the gaps, I'm also shading onto the bubbles a few at a time. Just make sure that the tone is varied on each circle, otherwise it'll all merge into one and just look like one big pattern. And I'm now adding some highlights in with the very point of the eraser there, just to lift some of that tone up so you've got good contrast between really dark areas and really light areas. Keep looking at the image when you're shading so that you can see roughly where the dark and the light tones are and getting that variety in there. Make sure that you don't outline every single shape. Some areas are much lighter than others, so they need less pressure on your pencil as you're shading those bubbly sections in. I'm using a battery operated eraser there, which is great for taking out small areas and getting even lighter. If you don't have one of those, one of the mechanical pencils is really good with the small rubbers. I'm just using a blending stick. Again, if you don't have one, you can use some tissue to soften some of the shading and make it appear a little bit smoother, especially on the lighter areas where I want a light mid-tone. Just checking the contrast of the drawing, making sure I've got some really dark shadows, and finishing off the bottom area with some darker tones. And then it's a case of checking across the whole image, squinting at it, and making sure that you've got three main tones in there: shadows, highlights, and mid-tones. Using the sharp point of the pencil to get some outlines back in. And I've noticed at the front of that suite it needs to go even darker, so I'm just applying a bit more pressure now towards the end. And that is the finished drawing.